Hi folks, I want to welcome you back to my channel. So in this video, I'm going to deal with Mikrotik routing. And just like in Cisco, we have certain routing protocols that you can actually configure between routers or between networks for you to easily manipulate your way through between these networks, as in to be able to easily access the other network. You can actually share files and data between these networks, which could be far away from you or could be in the next town. Okay, so I'm basically going to show you how to actually deal with this configuration and how to easily go about it. And there are several routing protocols. We have the OSPF, Open Shortest Path First, and then we have the RIP, we have the BGP, we have the EIGRP, and the rest. But in this video, I'm going to basically show you guys how to configure OSPF. So these are the routing protocols we have in Mikrotik. We have the BFD, BGP, we have the filters, we have the IGP, IGMP proxy, we have the MME, OSPF, OSPF version 3, PIM, prefix list, RIP, and RIP NG. In today's video, we are going to tackle OSPF, and it's going to be between two routers. So this is my first router, and this is my second router. This is my first router, this is my second router. So when I'm done with the configuration, we are actually going to test the configuration we've done and then see the results of it, right? So kindly sit back and then watch me deal with this configuration. Thank you. So without wasting time, let me first deal with the first router. This is my first router, this is my second router. Okay, to start with, you must know your network IP address and then interface you are going to use as your OSPF interface for configuration. So first of all, I need to go to my IP addresses so I can find my addresses here. Secondly, you need to locate where the routing protocols are. So you go to routing and then you can locate OSPF here. So this is it. The same thing must be applied here as well. So without wasting time, you need to first of all come to your networks. You need to jump any other interface, come here. But I know the interface I'm going to use, right? So I need to, my interface is the bridge interface, which is behind network. That is the interface I'm going to use for the OSPF protocol configuration. So I apply and okay. The next thing is for you to add the various networks you are going to use as the OSPF, because you want to be able to reach the other network from a computer somewhere or a host to the other host on the specified network I'm going to use here. So the first network, which is this router's internal network. So this is the interface we are going to use. So you quickly select this and then paste it here. Okay. The next thing is the next network you want to use as your OSPF. Okay, so in this case, I know the network, so I quickly do this 88.0/24, right? So this is what I've just created here. Now you need, this is a second router, you need to do the same thing here. So this is my router's IP, okay, for the second router board. And then you come to the routing OSPF, and then you create the interface. And in this case, I'm going to the interface I'm going to receive the OSPF, or I'm going to use for the OSPF configuration, is Ether 1, and then you apply. And then the bridge network as well. And in this instance, this is my bridge network inside this router. So the same thing, you need to come to your networks and then create your network for the OSPF connection. So this is my network, and then you create the network for the other router as well. So it's like they are synchronizing between each other. When you are doing this, you are configuring this OSPF or this routing stuff, it's just to synchronize between networks. So I have created this, let me see. Right, so as you can see here, we have just created this, and you can see two active interfaces working here. The same way, if you come to this side as well, you can see the interface up. So in a way, this looks like the master and this looks like the slave, because you have only one interface enabled and it's allowed for the OSPF. If there were multiple networks or routers, obviously I'm going to see more interfaces listed here, but in this case it's just the master, and then this looks like the slave. Okay. And so basically this is what we have created. And then if you look through the neighbors here, you'll be able to really understand. Yes, address itself coming from this router. So without wasting time, let me try and connect my mobile phone to this router and then try and see if I can access some resources from this router as well. So I'm currently going to connect mobile phone to this router, okay, this network, and then see if I can access my mobile phone's IP from this second router. If I did everything right, I should be able to access my IP address, my phone's IP address from this router. Okay, so I have my IP, which is 192.168.9.252. Okay, so without wasting time, let me quickly come here and then try and see. Right, so I can reach my phone. As it's evidenced here, you can see the IP here, right? So I'm able to reach my mobile phone. I'm able to reach my mobile phone from the second router or the second network. Now, I downloaded a remote desktop client for Windows. I'm going to try it on my phone. So I'm let me enable some sharing on my laptop. Okay, so I'm going to enable some sharing on my laptop and then we can go ahead. So basically I'm going to try to access a file from my desktop, and my desktop belongs to a different network, right? Okay. Right. Okay, sharing. Let me enable. Turn on sharing. Turn on network discovery. Okay. What else? Enable file sharing. Okay, let me save it. After that, I will disable what I've just done, else I'll end up being vulnerable on the network. Right, so let me verify the IP address I'm using, of which I'm going to use here. Okay, so this is my IP address. So let me quickly type it. One type it 192.168.88. .252. Right. Okay, save. Now let me try and see if I can log in into this desktop. So we are assuming that we have a server configured on this. So we are assuming that my desktop is a server and I'm trying to connect to it. Okay. So let me try again and see. Great. So now it is asking me to enter my username and password. Okay. So in a way, I should be able to access my Mikrotik router of this first one of the 192.168.9.1 from my phone, which is on a different network. But because of the routing protocol I've just configured, it should be able to connect to it. And then I should be able to get access to the Mikrotik router board and then have my way through.
Right. So I should be able to access this router board. I mean the second router board, and it should give me, yes. So as you can see, I've been able to connect to the second router board. I'll be able to connect to the second router board, and this is the ID of the router board, as you can see. If we go to the interfaces, you'll be able to, if we go to IP, you'll be able to see exactly. Okay, so as you can see, this is my one interface, the main interface bringing in the internet, and this is the interface I used for my OSPF routing protocol, and this is the main LAN. Okay, this is a local area network. You see, so I'm on a different network using a different IP, but I'm able to access the nearest network. So as you can see, I'm on 9.0 network, but I'm able to log in into 88.0 network, all because of the routing.
Thank you very much for watching this video. I really hope you now have a clue of how to set up a routing protocol. And this is not the end of it. We are going to deal with other routing protocols as well, all these other ones as well, as time permits us. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share my videos as well. Thank you.